Well, a lot has happened since I reviewed the shoes and said what my schedule was for it to be today. Yeah, apparently the Outlaws folded for the rest of the season and the game was canceled today. So we're having a intra-team scrimmage kind of thing up at Archie Anderson at like 3 o'clock. Morning. So, yeah, that was... It was like, I recorded the video at like 11, 10 o'clock, and y'all can flame me in the comments if you saw the clock in the background. You know, because I mean, technically, you can't see the clock very well. But anyways, so I'm just going about the day, covering things with like one of the linemen, yada yada, and so I was like, yeah, game. So I started watching Huddle because I wound up getting the film. So I started watching and seeing stuff. Poor film quality, but that's the YouTuber in me. I was like, hey Chad, I'm not really familiar with the Outlaws or the Mayhem. Which one's which? Because I'm used to a lot of our stadiums around here have only bleachers on one side. Even if they're large bleachers, they're only on one side. So I'm looking at this and like, but they're facing bleachers. Like, McKenzie has bleachers on both sides, but they're smaller. And Aberdeen has bleachers, but that's like all, you know, it's like in a horseshoe thing. But it's not very often that we have bleachers on the other side. So I thought maybe it was being taken from the away side. Anyways, so I got that sorted out and he goes, yes, it is the people in the solid red, but they folded and they forfeited. I was like, great. 4 weeks of suspension and I finally come back. To a forfeited game. I swear I predicted this with Malcolm. He's like, don't worry, we'll make them crumble and fold. And I'm like, no, please don't make them fold. I actually want to play a game on the 8th. This was like June something. I forget when. And it was in Snapchat, so I'm not going to brain blast to figure out when that one was. Anyways, so yeah, there's not much I'm doing today other than getting all my stuff together, because they're like, bring both uniforms. I'm like, that means I have to bring both cleats. Because I need to accessorize. Even though I'm not going to really probably accessorize for a practice, but I do know I'm wearing my sleeves, gray, I call them the sleeves grayscale versus the sleeves green tights. Wow, it is still early in the morning. You know I momentarily had to think, am I wearing them? No. Well, that's the girdle. Pants. That girdle. These. You've seen me wear them before. So, yeah, that's what's going on with that. I'm wearing these because whether it's black or white, it doesn't really matter. They've got my black helmet, mouthpiece. I mean, I'll just get all this stuff put together. The backpack, it's 8:50 right now, so I figured I'd just get all this stuff in. Coffee. Bread, yogurt, pills. I guess it's just time to sit down and do some world quests. Yeah. Well, we did some Heroes of the Storm for a little while, because I only got to be there till 3, so.
Yeah.
Like, if it was game, I would have said, let's go out and get something to eat or something. Why do I have the hiccups all of a sudden? I burped and had to hiccup. But just that little like that little tiny hiccup. Not one that's probably even gonna persist. He tried to play Probius and he kind of realizes what I kind of mean. He's like, you need to be a little ADD to play Probius.
Yeah.
Yeah, cause it's like, the unless you, you know, unless you're like really good at hitting enemy heroes with the photon cannon, you gotta watch that 15 second cooldown so that you can, you know, hit it, and get it within a power thing, but then you need to juggle two pylons at the same time. If you pick pylon overload, you have to make sure that they're both relatively in range of the things you want to hit, and have your photon cannon down to maximize your damage. But I'll tell you this, when you do that, you maximize your damage. The only way to get more damage than that is to have the super-powered photon cannon from the talents and stuff, and then have pylon overload and have 3 pylons attacking in like a triangle around the enemy's core. That's pretty much it. Because the photon cannon will every time it hits an enemy hero, loses a second and a half on its cooldown.
Ah.
So that's what that talent does, and it kind of sucks if it's not hitting heroes, because you kind of waste a talent, because there's two others in there there's another one in there that's really... Oh, it's the Disruption Pulse gains 10% damage as it hits things or warp rifts, up to 50%. So... The other one is Warp Rift, and if you're really good about it, like, it gets disgusting, because if you hit a hero with a Warp Rift twice, the second talent, the middle talent in there is really good, because you will do 20% more damage to that hero for the next 6 seconds after they get hit by a Warp Rift, so then they'll get hit by the next Warp Rift for 20% more damage. And your Disruption Pulse, which is already doing a fair bit of damage as is.
Yeah.
And if you got your Warp Rift thing up there early, it does an extra 100 damage, and then for extra 20, and so your Warp Rift, especially if you have three of them down.
Yeah.
Yeah, I didn't have that one quite set up, but there was a triple one that I had. They were kind of in a weird, like, that. They weren't in a full line. They were in, like, a thing. So I shot it straight down the middle, and Jaina was sitting in the middle of it, right in the center. Oh. It's just like, and just, I was like, I bopped her.
Miley Cyrus's Wrecking Ball. Better replace the name with Christmas Time Meditation and delete the words. I'm going to put it in with the church music and see if the pianist notices. Self-reply. He noticed. Now I can add Yell That by Two Priests at Once to my list of accomplishments.
All right. So I'm going to get some little bit of stretching in. Aaron's not going with me because it's going to be hot and he wants to stay home and maybe...
I'm going to work on some programming stuff.
Yeah. So I will chat with you guys probably up in Longview. Because I got to be there by 3, it's 12:45, so 45 minutes, get up there early, yada yada. Well, got up here, old familiar field, just probably bone dry right now. The gym up on the corner is yellow, it's got a raid coming up in 16 minutes, but it's 3 stars. Aaron and I could maybe do all that, maybe. So, honestly I'm wearing sleep stuff just because... Well, I didn't want to cake myself like an hour and a half ago and in a SPF 8 and then have it like kind of wear off or something. So I just figured I'd just cover it with fabric. That works. Got leggings on and everything. Got my girdle on, so I don't have to worry about putting that on out here. Oh. So, I'm gonna go check things in the car, see what's going on. Make sure everything's going. I had to go pee, because old man gotta go pee. And, yeah. So, I'm gonna go check the car stuff. Apparently, our head coach and one of our offensive linemen are going to be racing each other. This is the kind of crowd we have here.
Hey, wait, did we get a...
What should we tell your wife?
You don't want to answer?
Why don't we find out?
Let me videotape.
Hold on. Hey, man! Red Rover, Red Rover! Sean!
Oh!
Oh! I think that was the Lightning McQueen tie.
I got in my head.
Come on now.
He left in a buck shot.
You see those fucking dips? Yeah, he was going to
throw. I saw you pick up speed.
Hey, Sean, you should have led with your head through the finish line like a track star. You see this man? Bro, he show you his track skills? Because you had him at the end of the race. You had him.
Hey, Sean.
He did.
Yeah.
He did.
All right, I got to get out of here.
Oh, Levi, say hi to Brendan.
Hi, Brendan.
Brendan. Brendan, with an E.
Brendan?
Yeah.
All right, hi, Brendan.
I got sick kids. I got to go.
Well, yours got...
Everybody's got sick kids but me, because I don't got kids.
Hey, I videotaped that olive code right on your page.
You should make it up.
High def.
Yeah, there you go.
I can even get him a photo finish.
Theo has the video. Hey, Miguel. Theo. Theo.
They all arguing over there. I forgot my shirt. Huh?
You ready?
Yeah, I'm ready. But yeah, I wound up getting it. It's a tie.
Yeah, it looked like a tie.
Because I didn't know where the finish line was, so... Anyways, but yeah. Trying not to take my mouthpiece out, because I'll lose it.
Thank you, whoever said that. Thank you.
Who are you talking about?
So, okay, that works. Ugly shirt. Helmet. Oh, camera, don't fall, please. Here, let's put you up there, where there's more. This is the warmest kiwi strawberry. But it actually tastes pretty good. However, I'm gonna wash this when I get home, because that's gonna be disgusting. Put that and that, and that. Delvin Mandela, that's Bixby. Shut up, Bixby! One of these days I'm gonna have a vlog titled Shut Up, Bixby. Aaron, I learned English in school, but I really... Alright, I don't know what that's about. Holland Partner Group, oh, the pool party. Evolution Team Apparel just shared a post. Evolution Team Apparel. I follow them on Instagram. So, my new cleats need to be broken in. Oh, but they got pretty dirty. Child on a bike. And then, what's the other? That's YouTube, there's Snapchat. What's Aaron doing? What are you talking about? Why does your car sound like it's that much bass needs to just stop? Stop with the Wi-Fi. I'm not close enough to someone's house. Just use the 4G that's here. Oh.
Got a sandwich at Subway, and the Cafe Yum Gem turned into a muck. Again. Not even gonna try.
Sorry. Well, I can always edit shit out. Well, that was a relatively successful practice with very little guys here. Yeah, heading home now. So they're not really doing much afterwards. That was a successful practice here at Archie Anderson Park. Apparently we have 2 weeks off, so at least I got something in this weekend. Yeah,
That was a successful practice here at Archie Anderson Park.
Oh, it's good to be back in the uniform and in the pads here at Archie Anderson Park, even though we're going to have 2 weeks off, at least, before the playoffs. But, first seed. They were, like, I wasn't actually at the finish line, so it looked like the hair before it, Sean was ahead, but then they kind of hit at the same time. Yeah.
Oh, it's good to be back.
Oh, it's good to be back in the uniform. I have continued recording. Oh my God. Oh, first day back in pads in the uniform at Archie Anderson Park, soon to be our home field, probably next season, but we got first seed for, so 2 weeks off until playoffs. All right, let's get this shit off. They're still arguing about the race. It's been 6 minutes. I know that vlog hasn't been that long because I cut out all the time where I was doing social media. But I've been recording solid for 6 minutes. So, I have a sunburn. I can feel it. Just want to get the regular pants off. Hello, camera. Didn't even see that one happen. Oh. Now I just put my shorts on, we'll be good.
Hey, y'all be cool, man.
Damien.
Huh?
If you ever want to come out to my end of town, I got a hill you can run up with me.
Oh, I don't know what the hill, man. I don't know. I seen that hill with Willie and them.
Oh, yeah, the 45 degrees?
Yeah. You say you did 20 hills?
22.
Hey, deal, I can't.
On a Tuesday, I did 18. That Friday, the last day of June, I did 20. And then this Wednesday, I did 22.
For real?
Yeah.
Oh, good shit. Yeah, good job. I can't, bro.
Where do you live? Like, which state? Oh, little Brandon. You literally just commented on something. I need to tell Aaron. Okay. We got that. We got this. Zoom. Meep meep. Not for me. I need my actual shoes on. Yeah, I'm developing that like weird sort of bruise. Ah, that you get on like the outside when you need to break in cleats. Because I'm an idiot. I almost freaking wondered where the camera was. I have a power bar to eat that's most likely half melted. At least I get to put into Samsung Health that I did like an hour worth of football. And then my cleat decided. I'll be fine next time if I have some painkillers. Because it's just an idle bit of pain that's like annoying. But if I had to make some Advil or some ibuprofen, is that the same thing? I'm losing my mind. All right, we got everything. We got everything. One fob, keys, wallet, phone, camera. All right, I will see you guys down when we go to dinner. All right, I forgot to say it. I was spacing out. So I was trying to do all the social media stuff before I took my pads off, because I know that a lot of people around the world that watch my social media for football like to see the look of football. It's branding, I guess. So I was too busy doing that, and they were all talking about the foot race. And so I forgot to say that I was playing a little bit of a linebacker today. I didn't get any footage because Aaron wasn't here. And we didn't actually have that many guys. So I wound up with playing at least an inside linebacker for a while and then an outside linebacker. Probably just because they needed me to put someplace. But I was in for a good long time before my lips and stuff started drying out. It was very, very... Being next to a river makes it really dry. And I'm hiccuping because it's actually dry. That and my power bar was half melted, so I had to run in front of the air conditioner just to solidify it a little bit, and that's disgusting. You guys see that? Tore up, yeah. I got some tackles in. I may have some bruises. I don't know what's going to be going on right here. That's where David and I collided. David was just a little too much lower than me, and so he chucked me and pancaked me, I guess is the term, but my ear was ringing. So I'm driving down Highway 3. I'm cruise controlling at about 61 miles an hour, 62. The speed limit, I believe, is 55. I don't care. But I didn't want to drive down I-5. Controlling on a back road, getting like 30 miles a gallon, but I'm also running the AC. Yeah. But, so, I was in actually a corner up a lot. And then, yeah, then they put me in because BK had to go down to lineman, to defensive end, because Brian had to step out for a little bit. And so I went in at Will linebacker, weak linebacker, whatever, the other linebacker. And then someone else had to step out, so they moved me out to one of the outside linebackers. I gave up a play because I was still like, it's all still there. It was only a month. But anyways, I got to focus on the driving. So I wore GK's black jersey for a little while because they didn't have mine while we were doing defense and going team, working drills and stuff. And then after that, we basically, the two quarterbacks played rock, paper, scissors to pick who chose first. And they started going back and forth, picking this person, picking this person, picking this person. And I'm just like sitting there like panting. And they're like, oh, well, shit, I guess we get Theo then.
my brain was like, yeah, I got picked last. So yeah, I will chat with you guys when we go see dinner. I will be eating dinner. Aaron may be seeing dinner. Okay, I said we were gonna talk at dinner, but that's Banning's. And I had tachos and BLT sandwich. What did you have? Well, we have light. We don't have light in the car.
I had a crazy good chicken and tomato broth with angel hair pasta soup that was crazy good. And I had steak medallions over mashed potatoes with mushrooms and gravy and
asparagus. And the asparagus was like around the edge, soaking in the gravy the entire time, or the meat juicy stuff.
It was gravy.
And I basically stuffed myself with bar food, so I'm probably gonna go home because I'm starting to get like loopy, let alone this person did not park. I think I have an idea who it is because the car is very, very hot and there was like a whole group of people that came walking in. And I was just like, what the fudge? But anyways.
Don't have light in the car.
But yeah, so I'm gonna head home. I'm probably gonna crash. Aaron needs to press on legs. They are cramping.
Don't have Doctor Who.
Now we'll watch that one tomorrow anyways.
True.
Oh my god, it's Saturday night. It feels so much later.
Yeah, it feels like a Sunday.
It's because yesterday you were at work with nobody there.
It's so weird to do that. Try it sometime. Even if it's the weekend, just go into wherever you work when nobody's there. It is so weird.
That would be weird for Matt, considering he works at a Best Buy. It would be weird to walk inside an abandoned Best Buy.
Yeah.
Oh.
But yeah, let's get home.
Before I pass out?
Yeah.
Morning. Samsung Health asked me this morning, how well did you sleep? And I'm like, I literally woke up and I started going to the bathroom. Like, I woke up and I walked into the bathroom. And I was like holding onto my phone, listening to Pandora, and I heard the little whoop whoop. It's my notification sound, and I looked down at Samsung's health, like, how well did you sleep? And I'm like, can I pee? And I don't know, apparently pretty well, because I don't know when I went to bed. We came home for Dark Matter, but Comcast was not having it on the on demand. It played the previous episode, but it didn't play last Friday night's episode. I am not awake. I'm waiting to see if this develops into anything. I think that's where David collided. That's in the same vicinity where I got trucked. Oh, I feel something over here too. Anyways, so I'll see how this works out because like it's already made a mark and that means that my shoulder pad's dug into me hard. That's good. That's pro for the shoulder pads. Ah, nice. Nice. I don't want to say I was happy for getting trucked. I don't. You shouldn't get trucked. Much like you. There's much thing, but just take it a hit like that. Oh my god, I love it. Sorry. Like I said, it's one of those things. The football guys understand. Even if you get trucked, still like you got back up. And you have some bruises afterwards, but it's like, I don't know. Y'all know what I mean. But anyways, so I got coffee left from last night, but that's not good. That's not good enough. I gotta go take care of, my God, I didn't do Heroes of, yes I did. I'm like, I didn't do Heroes of the Storm yesterday. Cause like from 1:30 to whenever I went to bed was not, that was my day. As I woke up and anyways,
look at my cleats! Look at my cleats!
Oh. Where are the white ones? So I threw everything off, basically, in the back of the truck. It's not a truck. That is nowhere close to a truck. That is like the last thing, aside from like an Urkel car. A truck. The Prius. That's the one I relatively wore because people look at you funny when you're only wearing undergear. Only wearing undergear. I was gonna wash this. I should probably do that right now. Yeah. Do not lose you. I love you so much, my Sisu mouthguard. The cleats held up pretty well. for running on concrete. I should probably give him a washdown, because I'm going to be that guy. This one took the brunt of everything, it looks like. Of course, it is my right foot. 7:32. I want to start my music back up. This means I want to have a monetized video. Alright, got out of mud. Went over and did a gym at the Christian store. It was a raid. It's a little Quelava. Gets Aaron more candy so he can get himself a Typhlosion, because he didn't actually go out and get a lot of the Cyndaquils when they were out during the fire event. So, Brad should be down here at like 2, but he's always gonna have like, it's always like a weird timing as he doesn't know how long it's gonna take, so.
Yeah.
I should probably lotion up, like slightly scrub and get all the oil off and then lotion up my face. Looks a little redder. Anyways, so I'm gonna go shopping, hang out with him, then I'm heading down to go either practice with or just watch the gay flag team do their thing. So, being here at Freddy's, we realized that, I'm like, oh, I saw a Lay's display, so I asked Google about the Do Us a Flavor. Yeah, the thing is, it has a countdown of like 21 hours, because they're down to 10. And I'm like, but I don't want to vote online anymore, I want to eat. I want to eat your magic chips. Apparently they don't want us to eat their magic chips. They want to keep us having us voting online where they can sell ads rather than actually make money. Whatever. I always come in here because you never know. There's always like a spontaneous like, oh my god, I need this piece of clothing. A tank top has a pocket on it. It always weirds me out when like a parent is talking to their child in another language, and their child is responding back to them in English.
Yeah.
A mic. This is weird. See, these like, these are so weird and stupid because they have like a hood, but they're short sleeved, but they have a pocket. And I would wear something that tacky if they didn't have a pocket. You aren't. You wanna put it on and put in a comment about your look? Is it a fedora?
It's a faux leather fedora. Snakeskin.
Do you need to go to the bathroom and like cleanse your hands? Plunge them in hellfire?
Might not help.
True. See, like these, they're relatively okay. You know, because they're hooded, thin, long sleeved, but they zip up. Which is fine, that's just easy to put on. But it's like, why do things have to have little pockets in them? Do people even use the pockets?
Fashion.
Why is there a tank top with a pocket? Not enough people smoke, and that's the only thing you could put in there. Let's go spin the stop and get out of here. We have everything, right?
Yep.
Don't need anything more? Don't need any random sports stuff? Don't need any, buy any candy to ship to Germany for an obscene amount of money? I should check their DHL. She sent me the link for DHL. Which means a package you'll probably get into America and then get lost in the DHL system we have here. Sorry, Germany. You have a great system and it works over there for Europe, but it does not. DHL does not work here very well. We have FedEx. It's not a bad system. It's just that we have UPS, FedEx, and USPS. And they're all competing with each other as is.
And now we've got Amazon.
All right,
the Uber of package delivery.
All right, made it down here to I Need to Not Be Backlit by Buckman Field. It's soccer. They got like uprights, so that's good. But there's the flag team. I'm just down here, I'm watching. Because I'm out for blood ever since yesterday, so. Not against David, but I'm definitely feeling the itch, and I want to end somebody sometime, so I'm going to build it up for like 2 weeks and bring the intensity on the playoffs. But I should probably check in on my social medias, because I'm trying to build a social media empire here. But yeah, they're kind of surprised that I play full contact, which is strange, but to me it's just so commonplace. Sorry, I was checking to see if my phone was all whacked out. But yeah, like, I'm not sure what the rules of the field are and whatnot, but hang on. Damn it, that is not the button. New phone. But yeah, there's the field. It's got, obviously, soccer goals.
Only this field has uprights, though. But then again, it's Benson High School, so there we go, much better. But yeah, there's like a radio tower, a transmitter tower. We're right really close. We're right really close to Lloyd Center. So, can I see the building Aaron used to work at? No. Wait. There we are. It's that one. Before his company moved, that tower. My finger. Oh my God, my fingers. But yeah, that's the Oregon Tower. But yeah, Buckman is, or Benson High School is a technical specialized school, so that's probably why they have a radio tower there. They probably have a radio station. But anyways, so I'm going to check out what's going on here, check in with my social medias.
1, 2, 3,
that's a gay flag team right there. Oh, we're on offense now. Oh, dang. Counting off. The ref guy.
Oh, he's counting off how many seconds before the first could rush.
Quarterback has 7 seconds to get rid of the ball or it's a sack.
Oh, that's a,
oh, they okay. Just have seven seconds, period.
You have seven seconds to get rid of it.
Oh, okay.
That makes a lot of sense.
Whoever's rushing can't rush until they say
God, these rules are fucked up.
Oh, what do you play a team called Purple Rain? I feel sorry for you guys.
I play on the Cowlitz Cobras, full contact football, 11 man. We'll be.
I just run away from the rules. They have a sneaky way of between the rules.
7 seconds for a sack? That's like forever.
Well, the quarterback can't run.
Oh, well. And there's no contact? It's like.
What? To the left.
There's
directly at it.
Incidental, but no actual blocking.
Nothing that causes bruises.
Just threw the ball in the middle.
This isn't even my camera. I'm so not used to it. It's supposed to be.
As long as the football stays behind the line, you can throw it forward and backward as many times as you want.
That's not football.
What's even worse is if you throw it forward, you're like say it's right here. You throw something here, this guy throws it back to him behind the line, you can throw it forward again.
Uh-huh. I read that in the rules, that's why and then I read the no contact thing, I'm like, no. I'm like, I can't.
Stay in, Allie.
I can't play in this league. I'm way too contact.
Stay away from underdog. Underdog, that is a penalty.
I know. I have a friend who's played in. Underdog.
Oh yeah, you look at somebody wrong, it's a penalty.
I have a friend who's played in pretty much every flag league. He's told me all the various rules. I'm just waiting for the gay flag league to start up. They have 7-man and a lot more contact.
Hit the ground.
You have to replay when you need it.
I wasn't zoomed in enough to see it.
Chris, you know me. I'm one of the
wrong. 1, 2, 3, you guys are good. Stay in. You got 5.
I had nothing. I didn't throw one pass. I didn't drop one ball. And nobody I thought. You cost me a game.
Why don't you stand in and start looking at it?
Giving you water.
You guys asked me.
Oh, I'm going to so go epic on him.
Go epic. I love it.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Nice, Derek.
Take a nail. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Pulls up.
Come on, Jamie.
All right, come on.
Go, go.
you hear how much time we've got?
No.
Alright,
so I'm just gonna be right here. No, 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 no. I think we are like way high, I guess. I don't know, it's hard to keep track. It's so, the score is just so unbelievably high to me.
I think.
Because it seems like every time people go down the other end, they score. And I'm like, this is.
I think we were up four, then we got an interception. And we missed
it. I mean, to be fair, at Milwaukee High School, my team got 77-0. 77-0. It's also the best team in the Portland area that we went up against. I have no idea. I would think three per half, but that's regular football.
Hey,
Yeah, buddy!
I got you.
Go! That way! Chris! Chris!
Right here.
Hey, Zach,
you younger.
Hey, 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 hey.
Hey, come on in. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Is this effectively the last drive? That's, even if they score here, it's still not.
Is it 6 and a 1 point conversion?
Oh, the red line's out.
He's all over the line. He was on the line.
He's on the line. He's out.
He was right on the line.
Third down. He was standing on the line.
His heels were.
He was good. Jay kept my line.
Sure?
He was standing on the line.
Oh, man. Don't give me that Sean Elliott shit.
Hey, great job, kid.
All right, well, that was interesting to watch. Did things with the Cobras, not for the Cobras, but at least I wore my jersey. Got a lot of people asking me what it was all about. Saw two old faces, saw two new faces, and they had some free agents that they picked up for the game, so I'm not sure if that's there on their team necessarily, or if they're just for every time they come back out. They're just like, I'm a free agent. Anybody needs players, I'll play on that team for today. I'm gonna head home. Aaron and I are going to watch Dark Matter. We don't have Doctor Who. That is, if the Dark Matter thing worked. Unless Brad's still there. We played a lot of Heroes of the Storm with him. And since we were in a party of three, he got a good experience, so he was able to get some stuff built up. Aaron helped him fine-tune some things. But, yeah, I couldn't play in this five-man. No offense to the guys, you know, but it's like, you know, they gave their heart. There's no contact. I mean, there was a few contacts, you know, as you guys saw, but that it's all incidental contact. Like, the guy catches the ball and then runs and then run into somebody. That's incidental contact. Contact. But you KBPS at Benson, public school radio station. Cool. And it is right there.
I'm gonna go over there and hit that Pokestop. There's a lot of gyms around here. Aaron was not joking. There are no good gyms around here. Wait, that's a yellow gym. I could put something on that. Voodoo Donuts too? Nope, sorry. I don't subscribe to Voodoo Donuts.
Morning. It's a wee brisk. It'll warm up later. I'm in regular shirt and shorts and my new scent dolts, which feel very, 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 very small on my feet. Aaron's like, you gotta break them in. I was like, maybe. In fact, I think my old sandals might have been 13s. This feels weird.
I think they'd be better you can wear my sandals. Like, I think they're 12s, but they may be larger.
But forgot to say, while I was at practice, Aaron went down to the office and cleared up some things about the bikes and stuff.
Yeah, they,
Because there's three of them beneath the stairs.
And there's two more up here. They mostly don't care. Long as they aren't totally in the way, they aren't going to do anything. And they mostly are interns, so they're going to be gone in 16 weeks.
Yeah, it's like, and maybe one of the ones, see, that's why I think that they know each other, because yeah. They seem to travel with the bike back and forth.
They travel in packs.
Youths. Just like those kids last night at Taco Bell. Oh my God. I sent a Snapchat to Willie. I was like, if you coach any kids like these, I feel sorry for you.
But I also emailed customer support for Bike Town, and their response was, well, we'll make sure that we send someone out to make sure those aren't stolen.
So I'm starting to feel a twinge of pain right there when I put my arm too far back. Hopefully it's not going to necessarily impede any level of chest night. He doesn't get it. Of course, most of the guys on the flag team aren't necessarily get it. Because I was walking with a little bit of a limp and they're like, something wrong? I'm like, nah, I'm breaking in new cleats. And they're like, you're wearing regular shoes. I was like, no, at the scrimmage yesterday, I was breaking in new cleats. First time I'd ever worn them. They're like, I'm like, yeah, so the entire right side of my right foot is sore because I plant off it because it's my strong leg. And I was playing left corner, so I was having to open up, plant really hard, and dig with that foot. So they're like, okay. Like, I'm like, what? Because as Nick has told me, flag, by and large, is not that fast-paced. You know? Even some...
I saw the dogs and it reminded me of the running of the bull dogs.
Oh, God. Oh, God. Oh, God. I knew it was going to be something really stupid. Because the guy was, like, totally fearing. I thought it I was expecting chickens to come around the corner. Or, like, a bunch of people in bull costumes.
Yeah.
Kind of like how they... I've seen this one happen a lot for football teams in Europe. They'll have someone run around the corner and they'll hand a random person a ball and then the entire team comes running around the corner after them. But that was inspired from like someone in an Ewok costume comes around, hands someone a lightsaber and then runs off and then a bunch of stormtroopers come around the corner. And the person's like, oh my God. And they're all being led by Darth Vader in costume. It's great. A lot of different people on the train platform this morning, but it's good that they're using transit. We got this Edge at 8:42 and then Beware of Leaves at 9:30. Both single reads. Anything you want to talk about? Dark Matter last night? We were both confused for a good while on that episode.
Yeah. My jaw's still bothering me and bothering me more than it was. I think I need to set up another doctor's appointment and say, what the hell is going on? Yeah, Dark Matter was confusing, but it's good to have a consistent bad guy.
Yeah, the part of the issue is the fact that it's like, the alternate universe thing happened, it didn't seem like it happened that long ago, but it did, in a weird way, and I had forgotten that they'd come back with them.
Me too.
Almost like that episode would have made a little bit more sense if we'd have binged the whole thing.
Yeah. I keep wanting to watch Wynonna Earp and keep not doing so, because you're not interested in it, so
it seems to be, like, grim, but Wild West, but not Wild West, but I don't...
I mean, probably I should, you know, you should watch it and I should be there so I get the kind of the idea of it. Like, I don't know if it's supposed to take, when it's supposed to take place. Is it current?
No.
So it would be like Grimm. It takes place now. Supernatural or Buffy. Those that are supposed to take place in the present time versus older times.
Yeah.
Even though the fact that they're using like old style revolvers and stuff. But then again, Buffy used crossbows. And maces. So.
No weapon forged can hurt me. That was then. This is now. Fires a rocket.
Oh yeah. Apparently Brad will be coming back to actually get his furniture. When was that?
We're going to need to make an IKEA run.
Yeah, when is that?
Later this week, Tuesday or Wednesday, I think he said.
Oh boy, Tuesday.
You could probably coordinate
with him. I will. Because I have the appointment Tuesday with DHS,
yeah.
With PsycheVal. I don't want to, like, I'm probably even thinking about pre-recording Shrek Tuesday, because I got enough information on 13.5 as is.
Yeah.
That I don't need to do anything about it.
Just walking the bike.
And that I can just pre-record today, later, or even early in the morning. Because my appointment's not till noon, but if I if I record early enough.
Yeah.
But it's not out till the 18th, so that still puts me another week to put in more information that has come up.
Yeah. But this is my train. Bye.